Hello, my dear friends. Just got back from a week of vay. Spent some time with the Mickey and the Minnie and the Goofies. It's good to be back to talk with you and see how you're all doing. Hope you're doing well, helping others, getting your health back, and generally having fun on the rock while you can. What'd you send me, Hildy? 11-11, Ascension into the Fifth Dimension. And when? August 28th at 11-11. Supposed to be an ascension. You know, there's a lot of channeled beings. I guess I won't mention any names, but there's a lot of people channeling things, and you have to be careful about these sort of things into the fifth dimensions and things like this, because creation is set in so many frequencies and so many levels, but there are major levels that your bodies are at. And fifth dimension, you are from a place of pure consciousness, and there's no dimension to it. It is pure consciousness. It is pure awareness. It is that which drives creation, of course. And we know that in physics now. We know, of course, energy is the study of physics and stuff, or vice versa. And we also know, of course, that energy has intelligence, and then intelligence, of course, can be translated to awareness and then translated to consciousness. Of all the things that you do on this planet, becoming awake is probably the most significant to your journey in every way possible. Simply, physics and chemistry rule this level. And in creation, this whole understanding of cause and effect exists. Some at a much finer level than this, the pendulum swings pretty low in this lower levels. The finer levels of the pendulum, you don't see such a shift of the positive and negative as you do here. Sometimes you don't even know there's positive and negative in a realm, and particularly in cosmic consciousness in that level above the causal plane. You just really have a sense of separation too much. I mean, you know there's separation, but it's the perception is oneness, and this is what gives you the nirvanic and the ecstasy of that plane and anything thereof beyond into pure consciousness. Then down here, or we could call it that, chemistry is rules the day, but is ruled by, of course, energy and ruled by consciousness. And then the second level here, coming up in October, I'll try to translate that all down into the anions and cations and the anionic and cationic processes and this whole thing, understanding how it is the movement of electrons and how all this is. You know, we'll talk a little bit about some of the intellectual side, although I only want to do this once. We'll get into the Vander Wells and into the zeta potentials. We'll talk a little bit about this stuff, but you know, in looking at that, you'll realize that simplicity is a much better thing. You'll be able to accomplish more and get more done than to get into the finiteness of how energy is transferred electrically, how the cell and getting into all this thing, the markers on the cells and the magnetics of cells and how that affects what is drawn to the cell. I mean, there's so, you can get as deep as you want to in this field. Some of it's fun stuff, and some of it I left years ago. As soon as I got out of school, I did the Carrie Reams because I was a biochemist, you know. And when you get into biochemistry, you can initially get excited. After a while, though, you start pulling your hair out because you have to always be able to explain that which is with science. You can't put a predetermined consciousness or a predetermined outcome on a chemical process because there's so many cofactors. One of the obvious cofactors is absorption of colloids or the absorption of nutrients and how that is dealt with in the blood and how that is dealt with. and also the impact of acids and the accumulation of acids and how that affects colloids and ionization and all that. And we get tearing into that. And of course, you got your free radicals and all this sort of thing that also influences the van der Waals and how you get agglomeration and how you get dehydration and saturation. And how moving into an alkaline environment creates an anionic or an alkaline or a dispersing or a breaking up atmosphere or fluid. It's difficult to understand that even though we're dealing with acids and corrosiveness, it creates a dehydrated environment, actually causing coagulation and agglomeration. So, I mean, these are levels I want to get into, Mahesh, and, you know, talk to you a little more about that, but you're right about that one thing. That, little news, I guess. Look at this. Health problems disappear when captive gorillas fed wild diet. You know, I was up to the primate exhibit in Disney World. I was going to talk to them a lot more about primates and stuff. And what's funny is here they have these big gorillas eating all these vegetables. And I'm thinking, you know, you throw some fruits out there, you'll have a happier being. You know, so they're just feeding them all vegetables. And they're not vegetarians, they're fruititarians. And they even have that on their board there, that these are the exclusively fruit eaters. But they're in areas where they, mountain gorillas particularly, there's very little fruit, so you have to adapt. And adaptation on this planet is obvious. Look around. Gorillas, monkeys have adapted depending where they are. Some monkeys become omnivores. And then you have the radical chimpanzees that were in that experimental station that was blown down with a hurricane. And now you've got not even carnivores. You've got monkeys eating monkeys. So this is aberrated, bizarre, and way out there. But the energy on this planet is getting that way. When you see all these beautiful wells and all these animals beaching themselves and stuff, it's just man's playing with frequencies he doesn't understand. There's a good example of that right now is, what is this, the MIRA, Myra? Dry, Myra Dry. Now the FDA has allowed this, obviously. It is done by, obviously, physicians of some sort. It is microwaving your underarms. So you'll no longer can sweat, and of course you'll never grow hair there again either. That's the whole thing now. You can go have this, I swear I thought I saw it on a groin too. But they put a microwave, a radiation, into your armpit. And it, of course, burns real bad. You'd look up the website if you want, M-I-R-A, dry, D-R-Y, and look at that. We have lost. And so when I get caught up sometimes in the AMA, forgive me on that, I can't help it because this, it just is one bizarre thing after another. Not only is this not the word bizarre, but think about what you're doing to your lymph nodes. And what you're doing to your hair follicles, you're destroying your hair follicles because your skin won't grow, your hair won't grow back, and you'll not sweat again. So you're frying your sweat glands and your lymph nodes. Very, very serious problems can exist from this. I find the idiocy of man's thinking here. It's just when you have spiritual beings that come to this planet, you know, their comment is the humans. What the hell? I mean, it's scary stuff. If you sweat and stink, you're eating animal products. You're eating dairy products. You're eating dead animals. Dead animals putrefy. Proteins putrefy and stink. This is why when you start detoxing, you're going, why is my urine stinking so bad? Look at all the stuff that's coming out of me. Look at all the good stuff you guys are getting out of yourselves. We get pictures from you guys every day here. And that's cool stuff. I mean, this is what's in people. All kinds of stuff. And a lot of you are pulling your tumors out with the salves, getting some nice tumors out. I mean, nothing's perfect, but we do have help. And that is so cool to turn to the botanical kingdom, and there's our friends. And they are friends. Trust me. Big friends. Because when you put them up against pharmaceuticals, it's a no-brainer. But you've got a world literally gone mad. And health is very simplistic, easy to get. Just because people don't want to change their diets, I get that. But if you don't want to change your diet, enjoy your suffering. I get that. You know, and then when you get down to the very last stages of life, then you come run to a place like ours where we're trying desperately to save you. And that's about what we got here. A lot of poor souls that didn't know any better, that couldn't change, didn't have enough pain and suffering to change and things like that. So I just, you know, this profession is an incredible profession, but boy, it rips at your heartstrings. I tell you, to see people suffering is not really a fun thing to do, in my opinion. Health problems disappear when captive gorillas fed normal, healthy food. Now, the problem, of course, is, again, man's farm-raised food versus wild-grown food. Huge difference. You know, man just hasn't come to realize how vital his diet is. We think everything's either food, that reminds me of Billy Goat, or if it don't taste good, throw some spice on it, throw some cayenne pepper on it, and curry, and let's see if we can eat it. I mean, this is the kind of thinking that man's kind of got out there, and we have to change this, you know. We have to get ourselves back around. Those are going to survive this dimension, so to speak. Or you could go up and ascend on 11-11 and go on up into the fifth dimension. But those things rarely happen, guys. You have to be careful about buying into channel entities, because that's just what you get. You know, you don't need to channel. You are that which is. You don't need to channel anything. You just need to wake up to your higher self. And I don't want to say higher self, because you are your higher self. You just have to be it and realize it. And when you do, you don't need anybody or anything, because you realize you are the one as everything else is. And it's all you could be, understanding what God is. I love this one. Of course, growing up, I loved Pepsi over Coke. But this is pretty cool. Poor Pepsi. I mean, God. I mean, I look at this both ways. This is a complete your meal with a, this is at, where is this at? Kentucky Fried Chicken. And it says, complete your meal with a magic jug of Pepsi. And then it says, we donate $1, or we donate so much for, let me see here. We will donate $1 of this $2.99 drink to JDRF, which is the Juvenile Diabetes Research Foundation. I couldn't believe that. I could not believe that. You know, I mean, if the makers of Pepsi don't realize they're part of the problem in that way. And I realized people got addicted to soft drinks, but boy, you're drinking three pH acids. And the same thing with Gatorade, except Gatorade is actually more acidic than Coke and Pepsi. Pepsi's actually less acidic than Coke. Coke's about the most acidic type of Coke-type drink, I think. I think it's down around 2.85 or 2.9 pH. Gatorade is hotter than that! And it's like, what? Years and years ago, when it was hot out and I was building houses on the side, I would go in looking for something to drink besides just water. And so I remember getting an orange Gatorade one time, and boy, I got so much heartburn. I go, how come I got so much heartburn if this is a rehydrator? And I knew immediately it was acidic. So I knew that that was a lie. But I didn't know how much until we got the actual Minnesota School of Dentistry. Did a lot of pHs, and they came up with Gatorade having, I think, a 2.85, 2.7, somewhere in that range. I lost their stats, but... I, you know, when you see a university looking at things like that, now you've got a good university. You've got a university that's starting to put attention on the facts and on the appropriateness of things, instead of playing these pseudo games of chasing diseases and blaming bacteria and things like this for man's problem. You're actually looking at chemistry for the problem. And that's where you have to look, because you're a victim of your lifestyle, plain and simple, on top of your genetics. Plain and simple. Nothing else out there. And why would you blame other things? And that's part of how the elitists have done that, to make the common person feel okay. They can't control these things, but we sure can go to someone that can maybe have a thing. But what's interesting is, after you go long enough, you realize there is no cure for diseases, because they don't exist. This is all man-made stuff. These are just names for symptoms that... are a product of acidosis / inflammation. Bah, 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 bah. This is from Mahesh. Mahesh You're a good guy. I love this. He's wrote a beautiful little thing here. I won't read it all, and I don't think he'll mind. During meditation, I sensed how my heart took the lead with all the cells in my body. I sensed how the physical, mental, and emotional, and spiritual state of the heart was communicated to all the cells of my body. This happens through vibration on all levels, from gross to subtle, that the heart is sending out, through the blood flowing, carrying oxygen into each cell, and through the nutrition the heart sends, too. Again, it was clear to me that an enthusiastic, well-balanced, and loving heart contributes to all the cells embracing life and to help us reach the goal of immortality on all levels. You all have immortality on all levels, and it's called consciousness. It's who you really, really are. You're not a bodied being. You're an embodied being. You're only using these bodies as vehicles. Notice we lay them down and go on. And when you understand that or have out-of-body experiences, the fear of death will leave you. Only the manner in which, maybe not, but the movement from one dimension to another, from one level of activity to another, that goes on constantly. You're constantly on journeys as consciousness into the worlds of creation, because outside of that, you're just pure consciousness. And you'll see that life is an urgency to unfold and grow. You almost can't keep it down. It's like consciousness is ever expanding and growing like weeds in the garden. And being a part of that and knowing you're a part of that and understanding and being awake of that is the ultimate ride. And it's called God consciousness. A disappointed heart helps stimulate and support the death urge and blocks the inner awakening of our divine nature. I am sensing more and more how life's disappointments can contribute to embracing the death urge and prevent physical, spiritual immortality, and also how entertaining negative stimulants, blockages, plus the death urge too. Every time we are doing something that is out of integrity, the heart knows, even if the brain tries to trick us, and communicates that lack of integrity to all cells, which affects our immune system. And it goes on, and he it's a beautiful piece here. But Mahesh, this is why the word detachment, and this is why you see it in Buddhism, you see it in the Upanishads, you see it in Christianity even. You see it all through those that are true spiritual giants. Because the only way out of this place is to become detached from it. Your attention is what holds you here. When you understand that your very attention is the power of life, is the power of your awareness, and where you put it is your experience, then you'll learn where to put it appropriately, right? Mm-hmm. So you can use that for those that want to understand self and God realization. Use that to understand that. Because if you want to understand the ultimate, you must literally become the ultimate. Well, how can a finite physical body become the ultimate? It can't. Only you can. And of course, you're only using the body. You're the awareness in the body. And that awareness is pure consciousness. It has no form to it. But it is you. You actually have so much freedom, so much power, so much, I don't know what to tell you. Each and every one of you are limitless. You just have to realize that. Well, how you don't realize that is placing your attention into the physical world or the emotional worlds and making that your reality. Whatever you put your attention on and you make your reality, that will literally be your reality. And so this is something that... excuse me just a minute. Okay, oh, good.
Hey, how you doing?
Good. Hey, hello there. Are you going to turn on my alarm there?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, good deal.
Okay, so I just wanted to verify, this unit here?
This unit and
two more units over there. And they'll be tying into one?
Mm-hmm.
Or are they going to be...
Mm-hmm. We'd like that.
Yes.
Okay. I think we should have one code so everybody knows the code.
That's awesome.
I know, yeah.
All right, and then...
Thank you.
The other units, do I have to go through on the
other
side?
Yeah, go through if you want to. But okay. He said since these are already here, mm-hmm. It should be easy.
Okay. So understanding the ultimate is becoming the ultimate. You can't understand the ultimate through the mind. That's the trick. So you have to be careful, those in metaphysics, that you don't get trapped by the mind, and you're looking to experience God through the mind and the mental forces. Be real careful, because there's tricks right there. Another word that kind of goes with that, I'm just going to hit this on the side, is be careful with the word me and mine. This is mine. This is mine. My. You have to be real careful with that. That's the ego, and you have to be real careful with that. That can pull you in and lose when you're not even aware that you're being lost in that. So be careful with this. This is mine, and my this, and my that. Be careful what you want, because you create everything in your world, and this is how you create it. It's through your desire, and all the way down, the ego, the mind, the thoughts, the emotions, and of course into the physical side, and the need to survive in this physical world is a big deal too. You know, we do a lot, even though money is basically monopoly stuff here. Survival is key, and you know, you'll do what you have to survive that. So it's a beautiful thing, Mahesh, but detachment is the key to attaining the God self. You can no longer care about the finite worlds. You can experience them all you want, enjoy them all you want, and that's how you have a fifth dimension within the dimension you're already in. You know, you can shift any dimension you want at any time you want. You have that freedom. You don't have to wait till some maybe a spiritual event that's going to take place, because they are very few, if there are any. I've seen these for so many years. I've been in the spiritual world fields for all my life, and I see this every so often, you know, the ascension into the fifth dimension on a certain date and time. So one has to be careful with that. That's all I'm saying. You are the most exciting thing that's happened when you become awake to who you really are. And you don't need any ascension, you don't need any channels, you don't need anything, because it all comes from you anyway. So you have to be careful about opening yourself up, because if you're not in consciousness, then you're opening yourself up to the universal mind, and anybody can walk in and sit down and spend some time. And sometimes those that are real good at it, you'll never know they're sitting there. You'll never know someone sitting in your consciousness. A lot of people have entities attached to them that don't even realize it or know it. Just the way it is, and taught for a long time, but sometimes the general population is protected from the truth and lives in these surreal worlds of government protection, World Bank thinkers and stuff, you know. But whenever you have people that deal with money, or finances, and you put them in power to control, then this is what you get. You get a world of greed and money and everything like that. You never put the bankers in control. And that's what we've basically done, is put the World Bank in control, because I don't think there's any country that don't bow to these souls that are going to have some really lengthy karma. Anyway, just going back to this, thank you, Mahesh. That was very, very nice. See here, I am a 24-year-old girl, vegan since October 2014, and high carb since 2-3 months ago. I am feeling great, but I am struggling with acne since I was 16. You know how many of these? And really, we probably should just do one acne video, and because there's probably half of these are about skin problems, and I have covered them extensively, I think. Sweetheart, through these videos, because the skin is a big deal. And remember, the skin is tied to your thyroid gland through the inability or ability to sweat. So we're talking about this microwaving your armpits. Jesus, I tell you, when you're sweating too much, what's that a sign of? That's a sign of kidney failure, sign that your kidneys are not filtering, and therefore your skin is trying to make up for that. When your thyroid is low and your body temperature is low, then sweating is much more difficult, and therefore the elimination through the skin is compromised. So now the elimination through the kidneys and skin are both compromised, and those of you are those that are hurting the most. Those of you that are hurting the most with the fibromyalgias, the lupuses, and the Lymes probably have a real hard time to sweat. Most of you are locked in there lymphatically, and the system is just getting acid on top of acid on top of acid. Most of you also have the sulfurs involved. If you look at most Lymes or lupus or fibromyalgia cases, a huge percentage of them have high sulfurs. So it's just showing that just more acids in the body, more acids in the body. But when you want to go after a skin problem, you have to go after your kidneys. That's essential, because the skin is a kidney. So you have to go after all your kidneys. Also, you want to make sure your thyroid is up, where your basal temperatures are at least a 97.5 or 6 at least, preferably more toward 98, so you can sweat better. The other thing is filtration of the kidneys. Remember, you want to check your urine in a mason jar and make sure there's a lot of sediment in that urine. Because if you're not getting sediment, if you're not filtering, but to have skin problems is a rule, you're not filtering. That's just when you start to see inflammation in the body, you know immediately something's obstructed because you're starting to back up with acids. Well, what system are you in? You're in the lymphatic system, and that includes the kidneys and the skin. This is a sewer system, truthfully, like no other. I don't know how many cells feed each lymph node, but you've got a lot of cells feeding into lymph nodes. And you guys out there that are diagnosed with the cancers, if you let them take your lymph nodes, you are extremely compromising your life. They know that, and if they don't, and I don't know what to say. You're going into a modality that's pretty ignorant about the truth of health. And that's serious stuff. You know, when you go in and your treatment kills you, pretty serious stuff, okay? So, and you see this. It's like this microwaving your armpit crap. I mean, this is serious stuff. When you realize what those axillary lymph nodes are for, and it's not only just the breast or chest area that they, it's the neck and it's the arm. So you start removing too much of this and you've got lymphedema in the arm, the neck, and the breast area, nothing can save you. How do you get that out of there then? I mean, there's nothing magic here. This isn't magic stuff, voodoo stuff. This is science and reversing how you created your problems. So this is why you have to be aware of this. And of course, we have to all be aware of sitting on top of all this bad food and dietary insanity of the planet is your genetic weaknesses from eating those kind of foods ancestrally. So, you know, we go by, our ancestors started it off by saying, you know, let's move out of the tropics. And therefore, the downhill slide began. So this lovely girl has had acne since she was 16. She was probably born with kidney and adrenals, maybe not quite to the point she saw this earlier. I have watched Dr. Morse's on YouTube and want some help to what kind of herbs should I take to definitely cure my acne. I can't eat tomatoes and other foods, and you know why? Because they're acidic. You know, when you're acidic, don't be going and picking the acidic foods. And this is also true of fruits sometimes. You know, there's a category in fruits called acid fruits. And of course, they have the oranges and they have the grapefruits and the lemons and the kiwis and the pomegranates and stuff. But here's the thing. Oranges grown properly, organically grown properly, picked ripe, wouldn't be in that category. They would be in the subacid category. But because we stimulate our tree growth for higher yield of productions, which is a nitrogen hit, we're acidifying the trees more. We're also then picking unripe. So in time, it's kind of like in chemistry, when you have ionization, where you have an X amount, you have a rush of electrons. Initially, any colloid is going to have a rush of electrons first. So, but there's a saturation point of that electron rush to where then you can pull in the acid side. This is what you see always going on in there. And the bottom line is all things turn to acids anyway. All bases turn to acids. Everything turns to acids in the final analysis. Because you're either going to salt them out or whatever you're going to do, you're going to end up in that process. So it's just enough to say that this whole movement of creation and this and the way we raise things and all this energy and all this properly ratioed chemistry, if I can put it in that way, depends upon the health of the soils and all these other things. And it's not just a chemical exchange, it's an electrical exchange. There's an electrical change in the soils. It's one thought that a tree really doesn't burn the nutrition in the ground. It doesn't need to take the minerals up out of the ground. It uses the electrical properties of the minerals in the ground, not the minerals themselves. Therefore, it doesn't deplete the ground. I don't know. I don't know where I'm at on that one. I know trees get back by the leaves and everything else. But, you know, there's a lot to this in terms of magnetic transference of energy or consciousness. I mean, you almost have to break the way you look off in segments, because you can look at the whole thing of health through the mind, but you can also look the way of health through consciousness. So there's different levels of way we look at our health issues. I'm trying to bring them all together kind of in a balance for you so you can get some degree of balance. Then with that, you can take off spiritually, understanding that you are what you're after. You're after yourself. And that's why taking those times alone is key to you connecting with yourself again. Shutting down that mind from thinking. Shutting down those emotions from desiring. Jesus said it, Buddha said it. Those are the two predominant beings that have said a great deal about detachment. Put your work on the inner worlds or your inner self as opposed to your outer self, basically. There's an old saying, you have to go in to get out. So you can't eat acid-forming foods, but I tell you what, honey, I'd go on it just like our John, is it? 15-year-old young man, had acne all his life since he was 6 years or something, or 6 months old, going on grape fast and lemon juice fast. That's how you do it. This young man knows and caught the truth, and now he's cleaning his acne and it's almost gone. That's how you do it. To clean the body, you have to turn to fruits and berries and melons. That's simple. You can have your salads and veggies later, but to clean the body, you're looking for more astringent electrical foods, and that's just what you get with fruits, berries, and melons. Keeping in mind that fasting is the end-all in terms of the ultimate way to detox or clean the body. In today's world of high acidosis, high toxicity in people, and high sulfurs, I don't believe water fasting is essential right now. I think it is vital to get everything filtering, get your kidneys worked up with the fruits and the berries in it, and use the herbs. Now you're regenerating tissue, you're cleaning, you're doing all kinds of things. Then water fast it, you get a certain point. Now you got the best of all things, you don't stress yourself, everything is good. So, you want to take off and detoxify yourself, sweetie. In detoxification, you're always, so every one of you really, always in detoxification, you're going after the lymphatic system. You're not going after the blood. And you don't need to go after the blood. Because by doing proper detoxification, the blood gets cleaned first. You know, because you're putting the fruits, berries, and melons right into the body and the herbs, the blood gets it first, for the most part. So the blood, you don't have to worry about it. The only thing you have to worry about is circulation. And circulation is impaired by what? The lymphatic system, not the blood system. The blood system is a base system. Remember, nature favors a negative charge, an alkaline charge, an alkaline chemistry. And that's just essential in that. When you translate negative charges and all this to alkalinity, you start to see. But in alkalinity and ionization of these, you find then hydration starting to take place. And then you see that whole movement of electrons, and then you see the saturation, but then you get to that saturation, and now you're pulling in the acid side of chemistry. So, number one, uno, diet, central, change it, get focused. Know that you got to do a little few months, 4, 5, 6 months of fruit, berries, and melons. Then starve, eat all you want. There's nothing to starve about it. The problem with this is you could get high energy and a lot of health. Initially, you guys might feel low energy if you're a meat eater where you're used to getting stimulants from your meats. Now, herb-wise, always, always, you're working on the lymphatic system. And the lymphatic system has the kidneys and the skin, which is the third kidney, involved. So where would you go? You're going to go to your kidneys. So in herbs, you're going to look for herbs for the kidneys, right? Right. Now, what sits on top of the kidneys? The adrenal glands, and they control the kidneys. And what are they linked to your inner bodies? Your astral or emotional body. And that's your emotions. So when you have weak adrenals, you have anxieties. You have emotional problems. And of course, since that all is linked to neurotransmitters, then it affects the autonomic nervous system. So you feel it in the pit of the stomach, in the ganglia of the neural, the autonomic. And so you see the nervous system going down, and anxieties are coming in, shortnesses of breath, things like that are coming in. And this is all dealt with the adrenal glands and the emotions. So you're always going after your adrenal glands, hence blood pressure. Upper blood pressure causes systolic blood pressure. Your biggest worry in blood pressure is not your top one, your bottom one. That's your kidneys. And your diastolic, you must always make sure you're between 60 and 70. If you're not, clean your kidneys out. Get your kidneys filtering. Because your diastolic should always be 60 to 70, preferring 60 as best, with a blood creatinine of 0.4, 0.5 at best, and a BUN, a BUN, at a 0.3 or 4 at best. And that's filtration, and you're on the road to Wellville big time. So you're always going to take herbs for the kidneys and the adrenals. It's just that so many people genetically are involved in kidneys and adrenals, almost everyone. So we use two kidney formulas. Now, if you don't like the glandulars, get the adrenal gland formula. And if you have real low blood pressure, you're going to have to get licorice root and take it about a drop or full three times a day, and that'll help you to bring up that blood pressure and inspire adrenal function. But adrenals controls kidneys. Now, what else you want to work on? You got to work on the lymph itself. Well, the nature is full of lymphatic herbs, incredible lymphatic herbs. FDA doesn't like the good ones because they help to cure people. But bloodroot, pokeroot, a lot of you are using bloodroot salves right now. You know your black salves. And better a black salve than a surgeon, sorry, any day. Take that any day of the week. Especially because while you're pulling these tumors out, you have to also understand you have to fix the problem. Don't make pulling a tumor out taking place of self-discipline and fixing the problem, because you'll grow another tumor right back there. The same thing with mastectomies and lumpectomies. You don't fix the kidney problem, you're going to grow a tumor either back in that breast or on the chest wall, depending which one you choose. So you can't do those things. You got to fix the problem. And you can't overstate that. That's true naturopathy. Most naturopaths need to turn their head to true naturopathy, and hopefully, you, with the power of all you guys out there, you're going to turn the whole naturopathic community back to where they should be and away from walking toward the medical world, back to where they should be, into the natural world of nature. And this is traditional work. This isn't, you know, this whole idea that medical doctors have coined the word alternative, meaning us, is bull crap. We are not alternative. We are traditional. We've been here since the beginning of time. So us healers have been here all this time. So it's narcissism when you go in and say stuff like that. Oh, we're the main guys. Those are alternative people. That's part of that banker mentality, the Rockefeller mentality of power and control. How they sneak their little words into places to get and build a social consciousness around that. Well, we thought we'd try something alternative, so we're going to come to you. Oh, really? Why don't you try something God created, something that is traditional, and then if you want something alternative, go to the medical community, because that needs to be turned around. If we can't get you, you're going to need a medical doctor. I guarantee you. You're either going to need a priest or a medical doctor, because if we can't get you, those are the only two things you're going to need. Because we get 99% of everybody. But there are some people we just can't get for some reason or another. And we particularly hate to lose the people that straddle the fence. But you can't straddle the fence of chemo and radiation and expect a few herbs and raw foods to overcome something that powerful. There's nothing more powerful than an acid at the level of 2 or 1.5. And then, of course, even if you did, if you had a cooler chemo, but the chemo was suppressive in nature, you're suppressing a system that's already suppressed. You can't suppress anything in the human body that hasn't already been suppressed. So if you have symptoms and you want to suppress that symptom, you're going to, in today's world, since we're into the chronic and degenerative levels, you're going to pay a steep price for that. And a lot of you, probably this girl too, knows that if you do corticosteroids, which is a suppressant to this acne or psoriasis or anything like that, the blowback is not fun at all. The blowback is not fun at all. Plus, you're weakening the adrenal glands even more, which is weakening the kidneys more, which means that, forget filtration. See where I'm going with all this? So, you got kidney formulas, adrenal gland formula. You want to definitely get a lymphatic formula at least. You want to get in the GI tract, essential. So get a stomach and bowel formula, or you can get the capsules of Hillol tea, but the stomach and bowel formulas will clean the mucoid plaque in the bowel, will help to clean all this off. Aggressive bowel work, the GI broom. That's the best bowel work on the planet. Everybody else is making the clays and all the crap like that. Look at what people are getting out with the GI broom. You know, that stuff is a honker. You can clean yourself out. Get everything turned back on, filtering back on, because at your age, sweetheart, this is genetics for sure. So you want to rebuild this, and particularly before you have a baby, because you don't want your baby to wake up with this problem. And if your lymph system's a mess, your babies will be a mess, honey. You don't want to do that, because how they treat your babies isn't good. You don't want you to have a nice baby, and here's your sweet little baby, and then here comes the state, pluck steals your baby right out of your arms, and then juices them with chemo and kills them. That's what's happening at a rate that's alarming. And they're lying to the parents, saying, oh, we have 85%. One oncologist out in California told me he had an 85% cure rate. The kid almost died the first month. Hadn't been for his dad. I mean, this is just liars. You don't lie when it's life-threatening. That's not cool. Bad karma. I can't eat tomatoes and other foods, and I think this is only a sign that my body is full of toxins. BC fruits, allergies, doesn't have the existing. Yeah, exactly. Exactly. You hit it right on the thing. And it just shows how you're also acidic. And so when you bring more acids into an acid body, skin ain't going to look good. Ain't going to be real happy about it. And a lot of times you can't deal with acid on top of acid anyway. But that's how they treat you. You want to do acid base. And that's just how you have to go after this. Get into the base chemistry, which is the base or alkaline chemistry, which is your fruits, berries, melons for the most part, your salads and things like that. But in detoxification, you definitely want to get into more cleansing food, which is your fruits, berries, and melons, and then into some herbs on that. And that's how I would work. And you want to deworm it. You first off, for the first kit, please do, because it's got everything you need. You got your kidneys, you got your lymphatics, you got your liver gallbladder, you got your bowels, and you're killing parasites, and you got your endocrine glands. That focus is the perfect focus for detox. When you do that, you'll have a much better detox if you just go out and you follow some of these 1 week, 2 week programs. It's like, what? They don't even understand what they're doing. You must understand what you're doing, because it's not about just detox. Is just the modus operandi to what you seek. You seek wellness, a healthy, nice-looking body. If you seek that, then you have to build that, because that doesn't come too much through the channels of genetics right now. And look at the types of food man's sucking down. All the white flour products, all the dairy products, all the dead animal products, all the beans and grain products. That's where man's sitting and eating. So take a look around at how he's suffering and realize that's the diet he's sitting on. Those that change their diet, of course, see everything start to clean up, because now they're sitting on the diet that was designed for their body. Humans aren't designed to eat dead animals and their milks. Humans aren't designed to eat grains and beans. Humans are not designed to eat those kind of foods. We're not even designed to eat vegetables. Maybe cucumbers and veggie fruits, but take a look at the huge difference between a herbivore design and a frugivore design. Big difference. But these are the things that you have to do to get in there. If you want to get deeper, do like John. Go on a 10-day grape diet. Here's a 15-year-old man going on a 10-day, or I think he did another 10-day lemon juice. I don't know. This young man is nailing it. That's what you have to do to get to Wellville nowadays when you're this bad lymphatically. And there's no way around it. You are taking yourself back into nature and back into the world of proper chemistry and physics. This world on the outer got too confused and messed up. The mind took us in way too many directions. Undisciplined. We have the most undisciplined mind here. You go into some areas, it's scary to the levels that they've accomplished in the mind. Not so here. Also has spider veins. Okay, now be careful with the spider veins, sweetheart. This thinking about parathyroid gland here. You don't want spider veins. That's a beginning sign that your integrity of your connective tissue suffering. That could make for a very mushy skin. You ladies don't want mushy skins. You want firm skin. You want firm muscles. You want firm. You don't want to be mushy. If you're pushing your skin and you're mushy, you got some serious problems. So you want to start exercising. Once you get filtering, you want to build yourself up, but you still want to clean yourself out first. Get that lymph moving, because being mushy is a lack of tone. No, no, no. The other thing on this too is parathyroid glands. And you want to go after that a little bit. And we've got new parathyroid coming in. They're 50 milligrams. They're making them just for us. And so that should help even more. I think our 10 milligrams way too low, my personal feeling is. But you want to take care of this, because this could lead you in, and especially you're at the age of having children, and having a low parathyroid won't serve you or your child well, because it'll affect their calcium levels in their body. So they'll have growing pains, improper growth of bones, the connective tissue and the like. Also, it's a nerve transmission issue, so neurologic can be some big serious things there. With you can lead to postpartum depressions and that sort of thing, and depression outside of that. Depression is a parathyroid thing, so you want to fix depression. That's calcium, and you fix that, and you'll be good. So I would do a little body work there and pick my endocrine glands up and see how you do there. Jasmine. Thanks, Jasmine. Alexia. I am suffering with severe acne. Look, here's another one. See what I'm saying? There's so many of you. So Alexa, you can just address it right here. I'm suffering with severe acne after getting off birth control 1 year ago. Yeah, you saw the blowback. You know, when you take birth control, it's a form of stimulants and an acid, you know, and you don't realize, you know, because birth control is just abortion on another level. And so people are all over abortions and stuff like that. Man doesn't understand reality and anything like that, so a piece of tissue is life to people. Everything is life. Everything is alive. So when you pull a weed, you're killing something. For those that don't like to kill anything, then a fruitarian lifestyle is the only thing, and I don't know how you're going to live on this planet without it. Because there's a constant movement of atoms. You can call it death, you can call it transition, you can call it anything you want, but atoms are constantly being rearranged and arranged. Kind of like that guy that put that Rubik's Cube. Boom. It's like, whoa! I forget how fast he did it, but oh my God, it was less than a minute or 2 minutes or something. But that sort of thing. You know, it's a constant process of the movement of atoms from one thing to another. Consciousness just waxes and wanes with it. You know, and yet it's all part of one. You know, you just have to get out of the body and get yourself beyond the mind to see that and understand that. But once you do, you just a peace comes over, because now you understand how everything, or at least as much as you can, how things work. Got off and also had gotten my menstrual back since. I have been vegan for 3 years and raw for 10 months. Good deal. I might have to dig in a little bit, though, on the raw. Like I say, digging in is just taking the raw another step up, where you're getting close to that fasting area, and you're digging in there. Where are we doing in time? Okay, good. Keeping intake fruit high, and for a while only doing fruit. Yes, I was also on your herbs for a while, but couldn't afford them anymore. Okay, so here's what you do. Every once in a while, you can always, for you who don't have anything, every once in a while, write into Valerie's, my personal assistant, or one of them, and just see if there's any freebies back there on the shelves. The other thing is go to the teas. They're a lot cheaper. Go to the Heal All Tea. It'll last you a long time. Start drinking Heal All Tea daily. You don't have to overdrink it, but through the day, sip on Heal All Tea and use that as your detoxifying tea. You could get it. It's pretty ground up. You could ground it up maybe a little more and put it in capsules yourself. I mean, there's a way to save money and go on. The problem with it is we pay for all the bottles, and the encapsulation process in this country is expensive as heck. And there's only one or two left in this country that encapsulate. So it's just that a lot of little things that we have to pay for that we have to pass it on because nobody, you know. So the teas are the cheapest to get by. Also the three-lung tea, a major loosener up of mucus and lymph. So anything like that, you can get individual herbs that go that way. And then just use the Fab Four, a kidney formula, an adrenal formula, a lymphatic formula, and say a GI tract formula. Things like that. Skin formula, you can have just play with a few formulas. Really use your foods then to manipulate your detox. And if you're going to do that, then you shop into the grape fast, this lemon juice fast, that sort of thing. And just like John the 15-year-old is doing. He's doing those and he's winning, getting his success. Because it's just you have a system down. But you not only have to fix the system, now you have to clean the system. You have to hydrate and clean that system. Understanding acids is important to understand that. If we get too deep in the understanding, then we start to lose our simplicity, our ability to deal with these things, because now we let science pull us too deep into the world of mechanics of how things work. And then even in these worlds, there's plenty of theories that stop us and give us due pause. You have to always, in your research and in your theories, you have to always use what really works in humans. So when you take someone that is riddled with tumors and inflammation, their gallbladder's almost gone and all this, and you take them and you get all these tumors out and you rebuild them, which is just what any of you can do to anybody, including yourselves, not difficult, then it kind of really changes how you see things and changes the perspective of life and what health really is. And I forgot what else I was going to tell you on that, but I know skin is linked to kidneys, liver, and adrenals, but I am getting severely depressed, waiting to heal. Please help. Thank you for all. Don't get depressed, sweetheart. It's just going to take you a little time. Know that you can cure and get rid of this. Know what it is. It's your lymph system backing up. Know that this is a reflection of a much deeper problem, kidneys and adrenals. Know that if you don't fix this, depression is just going to be one little thing you have to deal with. You don't want to have to deal with the lymph system because you're talking about the diagnosed cancer side, which is your tumors and your inflammation, but all your inflammatory problems, your lupus, your Lymes, your fibromyalgias, all the fibroids, fibrocystic conditions, all this crap that we don't, endometriosis, all these things, we don't have to deal with those things. Take the time now, sweetheart. Relax. Don't be depressed. It doesn't take that long if you get focused. Get some teas in there and start detoxifying through the teas. See if we have everything on the free shelves. You know, we don't always have a lot, but once in a while we have some. You never know. And keep working yourself on every way you can to get this. One of these days, we get these associations, we get our everything done, our projects going, and we have income coming, and we have a fund. Then for you guys, we had a fund for a while, but people quit donating to it. We never did have a lot of money in it, but still a little to help some people. A lot of wealthy people out there, and they don't help people the right way, unfortunately. I don't know what to say about it. That's why we're not at the wealthy people. But who cares? I mean, who cares? You can't care about the money. You lose your spirituality. Nothing matters here. The only thing that matters is you and your journey. Are you having fun? Are you free on your journey, or are you trapped? Have you wrapped your world up with chains and balls and things like this to where you have no freedom? Because it's only you that can undo those. It's only you. No one else can. It's only you that can undo the walls and the chains and that bind you, because you bound yourself. And all you have to do is wake up and realize that, oh, look, I can simply let it all go. Who cares anymore? Detachment is your way, Mahesh. As soon as you don't care, the beauty and love and allness comes in, because you can't care for one as the world is all. So by allowing yourself become detached, divine love starts setting in, and you start loving everything, because you start seeing everything coming from the same source. And we need to promote that. Religions have not promoted that. These are self-serving. Look at all the wars we're having over religions. Throw up. If it wasn't the Christians, it's the Muslims. You got all these things fighting over what? Got to stop that. Got to love each other. Got to hug each other. Because we're all different. That's cool. You don't want to look at the same thing all the time. Boring. You love the differences. The differences, the uniqueness of each country and the beauty that each country has to offer you. That's why you have vacations. The trip through India. Woo-hoo-hoo. I mean, every country has its own uniqueness and its own beauty. We all need to embrace those things.
I've been here videoing. I won't interrupt. Well, I already did. I left a message with the Browns.
Okay, good.
And hopefully they'll call me back.
Oh, that's good. Yeah. So, I hope.
Hi, everyone.
Hello. We're putting together this seminar for hopefully next year. And so we're trying to get this put together, because you talk about fun.
Exciting. A lot of people asking questions and wanting to present.
Yeah. And if you're musicians or artists, start preparing, because I really would like to have you perform there. I'm going to see if we can get, Brian, if you're listening, you know who I'm talking about. Numbers on a guitar that shouldn't have been. Yeah, it'd be nice to have some nice music, love music. So there's a lot of good.
We want to do it. We want to do it upright.
Yeah, baby. But getting together it's nice. It's like sharing a meal at a table, pulling ourselves together and becoming one. You know, we don't want to fight amongst ourselves. We have to be strong. That's just what they want. Listen, the negative forces isn't just about the physical side. The negative forces want to pull you away. They want to build your ego and pull you away as separate. That's how they conquer you. Don't allow that.
Unity. We need unity.
Unity
creates
unitarian
strength.
Oh, unity. There's a unity right there. We do. And it's coming. You guys are something else.
I'll let you go, but I wanted to tell you about that.
Thank you. We'll get that set up. I'm looking so much forward. These seminars are so much fun. And we'll have all kinds of workshops you can go to and all kinds of stuff. Yoo-hoo! That's a big job to put something on that big, but I've always wanted to do that. Because we need to become one. We need to embrace each other and love each other. Why not? I love each and every one of you. Even if you do get mad at me once in a while. Nothing's perfect. You know, we're all trying to move through the insanity of on this planet. It is. Some of you are now traveling out of the body more. You're becoming more aware of other dimensions and other things. And so, all right, sweetheart, you're right on. So that's the best thing I can tell you. Dig in. This is Sophia. Oh, look at this. I have type 1 diabetes, bloating, lack of energy, and always feeling tired. All right. So let's look at bloating as related to type 1. Type 1, of course, is definitely pancreas, the islets of Langerhans, the beta cells. Now, you can either have a neurological weakness to those beta cells, suppressing the production of insulin, or you can add genetics within the cells themselves. Either way, you're going after the body both ways, because I really believe in enhancing the neurological system with it. Going after the adrenals, you can't help but do that anyway, because that's the autonomic. But also, you know, strengthening the myelins and everything else is a good idea. Making sure you're utilizing calcium properly. So check your parathyroids with type 1 as well, because all this, believe it or not, all has an interrelationship. Bloating can be from the pancreas again. It can be your pancreas is down and affecting digestion. And that would mean that your carbohydrates, which would be your vegetables, of course, and the starches, and the fruits and the berries and the melons, you wouldn't be digesting them well, and they would be fermenting instead of digesting, and therefore creating gas. or you have sulfur in the gut, which is creating bloaty, gassy. Either way, and sulfur could be a pancreatic suppressant as well. Lack of energy, of course, that's going to go to either, probably a couple of things. It could go to malabsorption with all this going on, but it also very much be the adrenal glands and low neurotransmitters. In a case like this where you're seeing these problems, always find the lymph system at the core of it. Rarely does blood create a problem in the body. You might have a problem with it depending on the nature of the chemistry you're ingesting in it. But once you learn proper chemistry and you're eating fairly properly, then keeping a chemical balance in the body. See, understanding blood chemistry and the chemistry of the body, if you understand that properly, will take you away from protein eating and away from this food, so you're looking at it that way too. You know, I buried this years ago because it's so intellectual. It just getting deep into that, and it takes you to the same place if you're smart enough to turn it in the direction you need it. If not, you'll get lost like everybody else, thinking you know how everything works and then using chemicals or isolates to enhance those functions. And that's what's going on out there in naturopathic medicine and in our field on the natural side. On the allopathic side, it's always just been pharmaceuticals, although there are a lot of medical doctors recommending now vitamins and minerals. I remember when we first came out with vitamins and minerals and other constituents, the medical profession reamed us, said we were killing people and we were doing everything. They came down on us hard. See, I've lived through all these years, and of course, Jensen through a lot more than me. So we've lived through extreme times of being chastised and called every name in the book, and now they're using them. Now we're not, or at least those that grew out of that consciousness are not using them, because you realize that there's a no-brainer. How many of you have stacks of vitamins and minerals and other constituents at home and you still hurt? And always feeling tired, so you know immediately. Well, you got a couple things going on. If you're not getting to your sugars, and this is why vitally, type one, my opinion, type one, fruits, berries, and melons. You want fructose. Fructose does not require insulin, so you don't need that. You want fructose because you need the carbon. If you're trying to get energy through glucose and you're a type 1, wrong way to go. It's an inferior sugar for humans anyway, and you need a carrier where you don't have that. You have, fructose is a superior sugar, and we're frugivores designed for that in the first place. So I would move my body up to 100% fruits, berries, and melons. Get away from your vegetables, because you're going to always have glucose problems. If you're overweight, you're going to have blood sugar problems for a while until you break down enough fat that you won't have that glucose loading syndrome. But I'd go right after that. I use the pancreatic formula to get in the pancreas, enhance it. I would use the brain and nerve number two on top. Those two on top of a detox program. So look at what our basic program is. We get into the kidneys and the adrenals, so you got to get into the adrenal glands if you're talking about blood sugar, not only just from cortisol relationships, but neurotransmitters relationships to the beta cells. See where I'm going with all that? So this is important to go after those adrenals and go after the kidneys, because it's the lymph system in the pancreas that causes the problem, either whether it's the beta cells or the nervous system anyway, even though the nervous system can have a weakness in the adrenals and reach and affect the beta cells. But then, if you know lymphatically that the pancreas is involved, which it will be, then you also know that your GI tract is involved, because the pancreas is just a branch off the tree. So you see why I'm always working on the GI tract? The relationship is obvious. So consider the GI tract the trunk of the tree, and of course the liver a branch, the pancreas a branch, all these branches. So you have to fix the trunk to get the branches to drain. See? And to get the trunk to drain, you got to fix the kidneys, because that controls the whole shebang. I've been on insulin for 10 years. We got to get you off of that. Because the longer you've been, Marcy's been on insulin for 35 years. She's just about done, but boy, it's taken her, 2 years? 2 years to get this off. And she's not perfect in her diet. She'll go perfect, and then she'll, she's like all of us. We balance out a little bit, And so she's working, but she's got herself so low, and she's only down to very, very few units occasionally. So she's down to little next to none. Pretty dang good for 35-year insulin, because you have to realize there's no more just about, you know, the insulin scenario and getting off of that and getting the beta cells to reduce it. It's a fact that insulin is a hormone, and of course that weakened the pancreas even more. So in trying to help sugar metabolism, you weaken the very the very gland that uses insulin as a carrier. So it's just getting in and cleaning and rebuilding takes place in a high chemical and electrical environment with a negative charge balance, or what we know as an alkaline charge balance. Base balance, I call it, meaning that nature favors more an alkaline balance over an acid, but not too far, because again, if you go too far on either side, you get burnt bad. But in reality, all things break down to acids. Look at ascorbic acid. It's just part of the cycles of flavonoid breaking down, bioflavonoids. We don't really make vitamin C. These are all parts of bigger complexes. And as they're being metabolized on all, like the Krebs cycle, you have all like CoQ10, you have these things released at different levels. So we can go to those levels and we can, you know, get CoQ10 and sell them to you, charge a lot of money for it. But in reality, this is just a part of an antioxidant move, which is helping itself into the cycle, which is helping itself in terms of metabolism and how all that is done. So everything in the food goes to its use and then its discard, because you have to understand that that food also has to be involved in elimination. This is why when you're on a raw food diet, you have no sticky stuff on your butt when you poop. That's starch, proteins. Can it take years for me to heal the damage? Not really. And it just depends though. Pull a picture of your eye. The right eye is where the pancreas is. Take a look at that. Also, while you're looking at the pancreatic area on your right eye, look at the liver gallbladder on your right eye just to see. Because, believe it or not, I've always seen a connection between the liver gallbladder and type 1. So you always see those. Everything is so tied together, guys. And have you had clients that have released their type 1? I think you ought to work with Marcy, since she is, or she's just in the final stages of that. But there's even a lot of YouTubers right now that are almost done with their type 1. So you guys want to communicate with this lady. After being on insulin for several years, does it take them years? I currently eat only fruit and think I'm on the glucose loading phase. That's probably. I check my blood sugars multiple times a day. I really hope it's possible to heal from. Absolutely. Why don't you hook up with Marcy, sweetheart, and she'll help you through that. You've seen her. She's a good sort, and she'll help you through that. She's been helping a lot of other type 1s, too. You know, I've seen both. I've seen type 1s swing around fairly quickly, 3 to 4 months, and I've seen type 1s working on themselves for a couple of years. And I don't know what to say about that. Everybody's uniquely different. The genetic depth is different. The emotional and mental components of the client is different. Everything contributing to wellness is different in the person. You know, their story, their journeys are different, and their suppressivenesses are different and all this. So I don't know what to say. This is why this is a journey for each and every one of you. This isn't doctor-patient relationships, you know, and those don't work well. You really want to take this in your own hands and be the master of your own journey and your own world. Don't let anyone else set and control your journey. Not wise for you or that other person, because for the other person, the ego just creates more karma for them, and then you get lost in your own karma by letting someone ride your ride. So it's better if you take control of your car. And it's not difficult. Learn how to stop thinking and stop desiring so much. Those are the two things that trap you the most, is your thoughts and your desires. And those are the two things that all the spiritual giants talk about, whether it's Buddha, like I said, Christ, all the other, Enoch, all the other spiritual giants. And if you don't talk about that as a spiritual giant, you're not a spiritual giant. because these are the doorways home. And all of us that have used them know that. Dear Dr. Morse, I was feeling extremely depressed while fruit feasting. Within 10 minutes of eating cooked vegetables, I stopped detoxing and the depression lifted. How does the depression lift that fast? What is happening to the brain and body? Good question. That's a good question, you know. I don't know if I can answer that. Because I don't know whether it's a fungal thing that you're stimulating or what. I don't really know how to answer that. Of course, it stops detoxing, that's for sure. And then, of course, it brings in depression again. I don't know, or frees you from that. I don't know. Can't say. Maybe one of you guys have a better take for him. I don't know. When you start on a fruit diet, it is so electrical that I don't know in the electrical department whether you can... whether that is in the electrical department that they're seeing that happen to you, or in the chemical department. Hard to say, because it could be in the electrical department that that's happening. So I don't know, you know. Yeah, too much electricity is something that's not working. I don't know, you know, I don't know. I'll have to think about that one. Give me something to think about, though. Hi, Dr. Morse. Colleen here. I love you and am grateful for you beyond measure. Love you too, Colleen. Thank you, sweetheart. A child in my life, one of whom I unfortunately have little say in terms of life decisions, has been diagnosed with type 1. Well, look at that. Here's another type 1 diabetes. She is 13 years old. Only 13. Well, you know, at that age, there's genetic weaknesses within those beta cells in the pancreas. So you can use the pancreatic herbs to incite that, because herbs excite cells. They turn cells on. But again, as we just talked about, at 13 years old now, Colin, you know kidneys and adrenals are at issue. Now, of course, with you type 1s, you got to realize that pituitary can also be involved here. I mean, we have to kind of look at all the connections that control the pancreas. You got to get up into the brain, the central nervous system, and the pituitary gland. You get down to the adrenal glands. That's your autonomic side of that. You get into the tissues themselves, the lymphatic system within the GI tract and within the pancreas. So, excuse me, please. So you have several things to look at here of possibilities, and this is why I believe in a total detox, but it's also why I like the eyes, because you can really get a good look. Do you have a lacuna right in the pancreatic area? And you notice that snuggled right up into the bowel wall there. Just a little on the outside of 8 o'clock or 7 o'clock. So you'll be able to see that a little before 8, then you've got the gallbladder. See what those look like. See what that bowel wall looks like right there, because you want to fix that up. Because when you start realizing that everything is linked and works together as one, including all of us, things will change. You know, it's not, we're individuals. But the irony of it is we're one. When we act too much as individuals, then that's when, you know, especially with the bodies, that's when we start, you know, we can get out of balance and hurting others when we lose the realization that we're all from the same source and that we're all individuals, all at different levels of journeys. I think the biggest thing is to learn how to carry oneself at lower levels of awareness. I'm just saying. So you know that that's going to be. So kidneys and adrenals always. Because when you're taking a look, you either have a lymphatic or a neurological issue of everything you're dealing with. Because you either have blood, nerve, or lymph that deals. And the lymph, the nerve, is cells themselves. Well, half of the lymph system is cells, and same with the blood. You have the lymph vessels, the lymph nodes, the kidneys, the skin. You have all these parts. So there's cells involved, including fluids. So there's not only tissues involved with the lymph system, there's the main lymph fluid itself. So these are big deals, guys, big deals. And when you realize the herbal kingdom is our sweethearts, those are our babies. Those are the babies that know how to do things. They came here with that consciousness. They know how to get into the body. They're designed for that. And when we get away from that and we start applying too much intellectualism, we are the losers. It's like the FDA fighting the use of herbs, and yet look what you're allowing. They need to go to jail for a while, sit around and play little games of Monopoly and stuff like this, get these big brutes with their AKs, maybe take them down in the jungles and play for a while. I mean, this is ridiculous. You know, you're allowing microwaves of armpits, knowing damn well you're going to destroy the lymph nodes under the arm. It just makes good business for oncologists. This is disgusting. There's no consideration of health and wellness in that field, even though they like to tout that's their concern. That's bullcrap. You don't get health and wellness by treating the body in the ways that they're being done. You don't hurt it to help it. You don't kill the cells in it to make it well. These are oxymorons. If you're hurting, it's because your cells and your fluids are acidic and your cells are getting broken down. You have to turn that around. You can't just take one herb or one pharmaceutical to do any of these things. This is a process. Just like it's a process to get to Hellville, it's a process to get out of it, guys. But it's a good process because it hooks you to living foods. It hooks you to the current of life. And if you're a listener and a meditator, it'll take you into the heart of God. Have fun with that. That's your freedom. That's your journey. That's the you that you so long for. That loneliness that you don't know how to tap into and win and find. That's the you that's always right there watching you go through all these things. That's the I, the watcher behind all your experiences. That's the real you. And the only way you can get to the watcher is to go beyond your thoughts. Go beyond your mind. That takes the watcher into activity. By kicking back to the watcher, the observer, now the mind can do its own thing. It's just learning how to do that. That's what Montessori really should be about, is learning how to both use the mind and not the mind in the children. Montessori education could be improved a lot. Now, but I told my dear husband that I would write to you. Please be so kind to speak to the fear of this child's parents' face as they become increasingly indoctrinated into the world of daily insulin injections. Oh, boy. Colleen, I can't even tell you. I hope the parents is watching this. The problem with daily injections is a nightmare, just from the activity of that and constantly insulting tissue. But insulin is a hormone and a synthetic one at that. So hormones and steroids, when you take them, your gland that makes them shuts down. As a medical doctor told one of our clients, oh, it just makes your glands go to sleep. When they wake up, they'll be stronger. There's no waking up. There's no waking up of the glands unless you wake them up. When you're on a downhill slide and you're using and you need to use a hormone or steroid to affect a symptom, you're going to continue to go downhill. Your symptom might feel better and you know, oh, look, I'm doing good. It's artificial. That's an illusion. And then when you stop taking your drug or whatever you're using as a stimulant or to replace the natural aspect of a hormone or steroid, you get whacked. You have to fix the problem. Man doesn't know that you can regenerate cells, you can regenerate tissues, you can regenerate organs and glands. But you have to understand why we're getting into these childhood type ones, all the childhood acnes and psoriasis and things. And it doesn't take us any farther than our dietary habits as Homo sapiens. Remember, we're Homo sapiens. We're not horses and cows and elephants. We're not vegetarians. We're not omnivores, dogs, hogs, chickens, and bears. And we're not carnivores, cats. We are frugivores. We're primates. And a higher species above that, even still, a more refined species. And yet, we're wallowing in the mud. And as long as man does that, you'll never experience health and vitality or wellness. It'll always elude you because you have not locked yourself into that which is healthy, that which yields. It's all cause and effect. What you eat has an effect. If you're not feeling good, don't look any farther than what you're consuming, whether at all levels of chemistry, including makeups, ladies. I said this before, if you can't eat your makeups, don't use them. This is the time you want to fix this little 13-year-old, because it's a living hell when you've been on insulin for years. It's a living hell. And you want to try to use something instead of it, metformin or something, glucophage or something, while you're working on fixing this. But you want to meet this child's 13-year-old, you want to get her on fruits, berries, and melons. You want to take a look at this case, because this is why a good questionnaire will help you. What all is going on with this 13-year-old besides the beta cells? Well, we know adrenals and kidneys. There's no question we know that. See? So we know this girl has to work on her adrenal glands and her kidneys. Well, that also trips us to the lymph system. But at 13 years old in today's world, you're looking at GI tract problems, digestive problems, neurological weaknesses, all from genetics, all from all of us not knowing what to eat properly and just listening to the herd, following the herd. And the herd is being led by who? Capitalists, Dairymen's Association, and cattlemen's industry, all these associations that think they know what's up. And these are all special interest groups. The little slick white milk rings and all this crap. Let me tell you, not good. And when we buy into that and fall into that, we hurt ourselves until we wake up and realize that we've been lied to by a capitalist society. It is all about the money. It's not about your health and wellness. I hope you know that. You're only a dollar sign to your governments and a dollar sign to the medical professions. If you haven't noticed, you need to watch some movies and catch up on what's going on out there. Documentaries, a lot of documentaries out there. One of the girls just watched the knife and fork thing. Said they'll never touch meat ever again. But this is what you have to do. You can't let your babies stay in these problems, because if you don't fix them, they're at a 13-year-old, a type 1, she's just in for a hell of a life. And then to inject yourself, that's just the light side of what can go on here. Sad stuff. All right, let's do this. Hello, Dr. Morse. You are the best. Oh, thanks, man. I appreciate it, sweetheart. I try. I mean, I don't know. I just try to give out what I know to be true. Kayla, oh, C-A-T-Y-A. Thank you very much for all you do. Thank you, honey. My friends are watch your videos all the time. I am 30-year-old female. Have been mostly eating fruits, berries, and melons for 2 months now, plus taking herbs and going other cleansing things. Thank you. I have a few questions. Okay, let's get into these things now. I have 6 veneers, ooh, wow, on the upper front teeth. They pretty much filed the enamel off these teeth and put the crown-like things on top of my de-enameled teeth. Isn't that scary? You know, there's no thought of why are you losing calcium and enamel out of your teeth? Could be acids, right? They blame sugars and bacteria. Come on. We're talking about acids, even sucrose, acids. We're talking about acids. And acids, not only the saliva, but you have to realize the teeth are set into the gums, right? And right into the bone, right? The jaw bones. All of those have what? Blood and lymph. So when you're acidic in your body, where else are you acidic at? In your gums, in the roots of your teeth, and in the teeth themselves. No different than any other bony, high-dense structure. So, number one, when you have losing enamel, you have to know that your mouth is very acidic, so check your pHs. If you have to use a little baking soda to keep your mouth alkaline, do that. But this is deeper in the sense that it's interstitial. It's in the tissues. So you have to get the GI tract cleaned up and all this cleaned up. What else could create a de-enamelizing of the mouth? A loss of calcium. And the loss of calcium, of course, is to acids. But then how about the inability to put that back? And again, parathyroid, TMJ. But after that parathyroid, for you, for those of you that can expand a little more in the thinking, think of pituitary just in case that parathyroid is being suppressed by your pituitary. You only have a few glands, nothing to get excited about, but your pituitary is the big boy, oversees everybody, and then you have your smaller glands, who each one does a massive amount of work, but I don't think anybody does the work of the adrenal glands except maybe the pituitary, but the adrenal glands, but that pituitary is so small you have to encase that in the hypothalamus, but the adrenal glands are amazing. They're just friggin' amazing for such little people. They do a lot of things. It's amazing. Just friggin' amazing. One of the veneers fell off a month ago. I decided to grow my enamel back, but I still have doubts that it is possible. No, don't have to doubt that. You can do that. But you want to make sure your mouth is alkaline and your parathyroid is up. So you want to clean your GI tract, get your kidneys filtering, of course, get your adrenal glands up, you know, and really start cleaning the sinuses out of your head and get your head cleaned up. Oh, you betcha. You betcha you can redo it. I had a friend that was constantly growing enamel. And he was all on fruit, but he had that damn strong constitution. Man, I couldn't believe that. I've told you about these many stories before. I know a lot of you don't like to hear my stories, but I decided to grow my enamel back. I don't have doubts, sweetheart. Know that and make it so. You control your own world. Each of you start controlling your own world. I'm going to make it happen, not egotistically, energetically. I'm going to control my own world. I'm going to make my own world. I'm going to control my mind and my thoughts. If I want to love this person, I'll love this person. If I don't want to love this person, I don't have to love them, but I have to love them divinely. I know of a lot of people that's done that in the past, sweetheart. A lot of people. A lot of people, and a lot of them on the YouTube channels, too. Matter of fact, Yaz, I haven't heard from you in a long time. Are you still listening, Yaz? You started growing your teeth back. Also, your teeth look great. Oh, thanks. You said they only get better after a six-month orange fast. You know what? Oh, no, let's talk about that. I didn't pay too much attention to my teeth when I was on that six-month orange fast. I didn't have any problems in my mouth on the fast. But these oranges were alkaline and unbelievable. That's what I'm saying. When you know how a true orange can be raised, you move it from the acid category down to the sub-acid because you're going, maybe I should take this down to the sweet because it's so good. I had never had any problems with that at all. My problems has always been lymphatic in my mouth, just like everybody else's. And my family lost all their teeth in their 20s. I at least woke up in my 20s about my lymph system. But still, I never got deep where I'm totally clean lymphatically. Would love that. Because remember, I kind of went back. I kind of got out of the raw when I opened my health food stores up. I got away from the raw a little bit because there was nuts. There was all kinds of nuts. I buy nuts in the 50-pound boxes easy. That way I can give you better prices. So I'd buy 50 pounds of nuts of all kinds, almonds, pecans, you name it. And pine nuts, I could go crazy over pignolia nuts. Oh, my God, I love those. Pignolia nuts, pine nuts, and raisins, or almonds and raisins. So I started eating those. And then there was the tiger milk bars. Oh, then there was this, and there was the carob-covered pineapples, and the carob-covered papayas, and the carob-covered, what else did they have? Carob-covered banana, pineapple, pineapple. Yeah, there was pineapple, and there was banana, and something else carob-covered. Papaya. Oh, I could eat those by the boxes. They were so good. Oh, wait a minute. Wait. Yogurts. Raw milk yogurts. Columbia yogurts. I sold all of that. I sold goat's milk. I sold goat's milk ice cream. Oh, I was going to do this upright. I had a spiritual book room and a health book room bigger than my office here. Because I knew I always promote reading and studying. But there's a point where you have to realize that there's no more of that you can do because no one has the answers in most of these books. You got to find people with the answers, and those are the people that have been long-term doing their due. You know, people that have ideas and opinions, those are a dime a dozen. Those that have been 40 and 50 and 60 years in the field, those are the guys I want to talk to. Now, please tell me a little about that progress. Did it take a while? Were your teeth in a bad shape? No, I never had that. Never had that. My teeth has always had cavities and things like that because my lymph system in my mouth has always been acidic to a certain degree. I've always been real cautious and careful, but at the same time, my problem is deeper interstitially. And it's just all of our problems, you know, and we lose calcium to acids. It's just that simple. And some people are born with parathyroid weaknesses. I never really had that kind of problem. My hair has always been too thick. My nails grow too fast. Everything has always been, you know, I've never had those kind of problems. But then I was 20 when I changed my diet. And so even though I've had my times of eating bad, I try to maintain a high level of raw. But when you start eating out of health food stores and you think this is all good, so I actually set myself back when I didn't even realize it. And so I'm going, I'm feeling less and less the dynamicness I was, and I'm going, why? What's going on here? I'm eating healthy, right? So we learn sometimes the hard way. And if I can save you guys from those hard lessons, let me do it. Because you can have a better, quicker life from having fun and spiritualizing yourself quicker than it took a lot of us. You know, that's the idea. Some of us souls here to make some shortcuts for you. And even though we have to go through some long journeys to get to that, at least we learn how to make them short for you. I do not want to torture my body anymore. The best way to not torture your body is clean it out. Get these acids out. Get your glands and organs all on board and fix. Your kidneys filtering, your skin sweating, and clean yourself out. That's not how you torture yourself. You torture yourself when you're not allowing your body to filter and eliminate its waste properly because you didn't understand that. So if you really want to help yourself from torture is you fix the acidosis. That then changes everything, including teeth, bone, connective tissue. If your skin's wrinkly, firm it. You know, if you've got wrinkled skin, you can firm your whole face. You'll firm your whole body. You don't live with wrinkles. You don't have to go have plastic surgery because what's happening if you're starting to get wrinkles? You're getting too acidic, and what are you losing? Your calciums. You can fix all those things. Everything's fixable. Like when your car breaks, you can take it in and have it fixed. It's where you take it and have it fixed that determines your experience for a while. Let me see. Two, after each infrared sauna session, my whole face is red, but the triangle around my mouth and eye areas are very pale. What would that mean? Poor circulation. But I'm going to tell you something. I don't believe in infrared saunas, guys. So stay away from radiation. I don't care how nice the papers are written on it. Stay away from isolates of radiation. Dangerous. I don't care what they say about it. You have to be careful. I don't think I can show this up on YouTube, but I have a lady's breast to show you what happened with that treatment. The infrared treatment on her breast fried it up pretty good. You want to be real careful when you're talking about radiation. Get a steam sauna. Get away from these things like radiations and stuff. Dangerous stuff. See how your face turned red? You burnt yourself a little bit. You have to be careful about things. Or you promoted blood flow, which is possible. So when you promote blood flow in one area and you see it getting red and it's white, pale in another area, what's that showing you? Poor blood circulation. I would probably do upper circulation and lower circulation together. That way you'll move blood more aggressively in the interstitial layers and help you to regenerate your teeth as well. But we're talking all through you. We're not just talking about mouth. You want to talk about brain, eyes, hearts, lungs, and every place else, don't you? Mm-hmm. Absolutely. I have a bunch of dark brown radiosolaris going all over my head area. See what I'm talking about, sweetheart? you're going to get into your bowels and you get up in your head and you get rid of these radius solaris, because those are the next door to brain lesions, which is then you're flipping you into MS or Lou Gehrig's. No. Get those babies out of there. Got to work on the GI tract to do this, okay? But use upper circuit brain and nerve to help yourself for a while. Upper circuit brain and nerve number two is what I like. But you want to get these out of there, and they will. As you dig in your lymph to keep getting, you'll see that those radii will get smaller, smaller, thinner, thinner, paler, paler. That's what you want to go after. Radius solaris, don't like them. Get them out, right? These are deep, dark weaknesses within these tissues. And when they're up in the brain, nothing good comes out of that, sweetie, and you want to get yourself straightened around here. I have a bunch, how do I deal with that specifically? Clean up the GI tract, upper circuit brain and nerve, get the sinuses to drain lymphatically, you know, start getting yourself cleaned out. The only way you can fix anything in the human body is simply get rid of what breaks it down. In chemistry, there's only two sides. Remember, nature favors a base negative charge, which is an alkaline charge, which is the regenerative charge. Anionic atmospheres are regenerative atmospheres. Cationic atmospheres are atmospheres where things are breaking down on you. But in that, you create agglomeration. Figure that out. It's just understanding dehydration, agglomeration, and coagulation. But it happens under an acid moon. I have been taking something parasitic herbs. Is there anything else I can do? These radius solaris aren't parasitic. Deep, deep genetic weaknesses. You have to regenerate the tissue. To regenerate the tissue, you've got to get your fluids in balance. To get your fluids in balance, you've got to start influencing the lymph fluids through the blood. How do you do that? Your consumption. What you consume is everything. Plain and simple. Could you show how healing lines in the iris look? How can I tell? Well, let's say this is a lacuna mark in your fibers. So let's say you have fibers in your eye here and you have this lacuna. When it starts healing, you'll start seeing white lines infiltrating this lacuna, kind of like your blood vessels look when you're acidic in your sclera. But this lacuna here is getting these little lines, and you'll notice it gets fainter and smaller, just like the radius solaris will. And that's what you have to go after. These are all very curable stuff. Yeah, you're sitting on time and you're sitting on work. But if it's not work and it's part of your beingness and essences, who cares? Because it's part of who you are. You know, if you make your detox your daily life, it won't be detox anymore. It'll be who you are. And it'll be a higher level of expression than who you were. Another thing, I flipped through Jensen's Iridology book, part two. Somewhere it said that if there is a surgery that a person is about to go through, the iris will reflect it. Scar or weaknesses? I'm not sure. Immediately prior to the anesthesia or the surgery itself. Isn't that amazing? That's real amazing. Matter of fact, it's so amazing, I never heard of it. The body knows exactly what the person is going to do even before it happens. Possible. You got one on me there, honey. You got one on me. I never heard that. But Gibson used to say that whenever tissue's been removed through surgery, there's a hole in that area, a lacuna in that area, not necessarily. I've watched this for a lot of years. The stronger the constitution, the less you know tissue is removed. Generally, by the way, there's a lacuna there anyway if the tissue has to be removed. I always see a gallbladder before it needs to be removed. So I don't know what to say. And I'm not doubting anybody on this, because this is a science that has a lot of growth potential, unlimited growth potential. It's like the autonomic nerve wreath. I disagree with that. You don't see, in iridology, you don't see weaknesses until you have them. You're not going to see your autonomic nervous system until you have a weakness. And when you do, that's expressed through nerve rings, not stress rings. These are actually tissue weaknesses, in my opinion. The autonomic nerve wreath, there's no such thing. To me, that's your bowel wall. And when you can see that, that's the lymph in the bowel wall backing up. And you will simultaneously see the malabsorption ring immediately around the pupil. And I don't know how many eyes I've done, but I've done tens and tens and tens of thousands of eyes in my life. Oh, my God. And I can't imagine how many eyes Doc Jensen did. Holy crap. I know he told me one time he had over 300,000 clients. And I'm thinking, God, Doc, that's a lot. I can find the page of that sentence sometimes. Yeah, I'll find that because I'm real curious to that. It's possible, of course, because everything is in, you know, everything works from consciousness. So consciousness knows everything way, way ahead of the time sequences of the expression. You know, that's why getting to you, working from your higher awareness, from consciousness itself, is always the cool and the end thing to do. For all reasons. All reasons. Yeah. Here is, I first off want to say how much I appreciate your willingness and generosity to respond to hundreds of people in need of change. Oh, thanks. I appreciate that. I'm trying. You know, and we've got staffs here. My name is Brian. I'm 17, and I've had a swollen lymph node in the back of, oh, this is good. Brian. Now, it's an interesting comment that you said at 19 years old, so I love you, man. Smart guy. Very spiritual guy already here. My name is Brian, he's 17 years old, and I've had a swollen lymph node in the back of my head, left side. I don't like that. Brian, we got to get that out of there, my friend, because we don't want a swollen lymph node on the back of your head. There's nothing ever good to come with that. And you start getting inflammation in the cerebellum, Brian, you'll get dizziness, equilibrium, get up too fast, you'll feel lightheaded, it'll mess with your coordinations. Yeah, we don't want that. And then, of course, the precursor of that, of course, is the backing up of the lymph on the other side of the lymph node to the cells. And that, no. You handle this now, your life is good, Brian. And this goes back to the kidney on that side. Which side of the head is it on? Left side. So that goes to that left kidney not filtering properly. It doesn't matter. You can't just fix one kidney over another one. But still, it goes to that left kidney and adrenal gland. Have your blood pressure check both sides. See if this left side's a little different than this side or how much different it is. For, I'd say, 2 months, and I'd give it much thought until I watched one of your videos about the lymph system. I got my mom, sister, aunts, and uncles hooked on watching your videos. Oh, thanks, man. The big thing is get this lump out of there. You do not want swollen lymph nodes because, again, that's a septic tank that's full. And it's full because it can't drain itself out. So that's a sign that you have a blockage on the side of the septic tank from the septic tank or lymph node to the kidneys. That's where your blockage is. 9 times out of 10, in the kidneys themselves. And it could be, again, the adrenals not allowing that kidney to filter, but it could be both. Doesn't matter. You're always going to work on kidney and adrenals. They're the twins. You work on them together. You don't want to work just on your adrenals and not your kidneys, and vice versa. So, yeah, you want to get this out. Put myself on a grape diet, you know, and get your kidneys, get your adrenal glands, dress that lymphatic system, clean your bowels out. You're getting up here now, so this is getting high up here. We want to get this out of here. Real important to get this out of here, man. 7 days ago, I started a raw diet, and about 4 days ago, transitioned to mostly fruit. Yeah! All right. You're going to kick its butt, man, because I know I need to detox my body. You have to. You have to, my friend, to get this out of here. You don't want to walk around with that. Scary. And the fact that it's popping up now means that a whole left side's probably involved a little bit. Pull a picture of your eyes. Take a look at this area and see what you see. I've noticed recently that the lymph node moves around more when I touch it instead of being very stiff. Excellent. It could not even be. It could be a lipoma. All right. If it gets too that much, it could be a lipoma. And that's a fatty tumor. And that would be better. But it's still showing inflammation in that area where you have agglomeration. So either way, you want that out of there. If it's a swollen lymph node, which will move too, you know, it'll move a little bit with that. Of course, your lipomas will move real well. You don't want a hardened tumor. When we look at tumors all the time, we don't want hard and deep red and dark. Those are not good signs. Right? The harder a tumor gets, the worse it is. So these aren't, you know, everything that's acidic agglomerates and becomes hard as a rock. Even though you're trying to burn and hydrate with your electrolytes, the problem with this is you have to understand. In understanding that process of ionization, you have to understand that typical diets are acid-forming. And so when you're on an acid-forming diet, and the formations of acids in the body is building up, then you're going to reach a point where you won't have that saturation of electrons or even protons. You won't have that. And that's what's happening. You reach a point of dehydration to where your electrolytes, you won't have that. And because mostly your electrolytes you're consuming are not as near as electric. You know, when you cook your food, you're disassociating and simulating everything. Okay. I've noticed recently that the lymph node moves. Okay. And is that one blockage that cause all my problems? Is that one blockage the cause of all my problems? Well, look at the adrenal glands. When the adrenal glands go down, just get a book at Books A Million or something on endocrinology or just on the endocrine glands and read about them. That's all you got. It's no big deal. Or get A&P for dummies or whatever they call those books. But get in there and look at that. But when you look at the adrenal glands, you have your medulla, which is your neurotransmitters, and then you have your cortex, the outer part, and this is true of all your glands. Then you've got different substances. So you've got an array of steroids like nobody's business. You got 24, 25 mineralocorticosteroids, you got your cortisol, you got your progesterones, you got your anti-inflammatories, you got your sugar metabolism, you got your mineral utilizations, you've got all your neurotransmitters, you got your epinephrines for your aggressiveness, you got your eliminations of your dopamines and acetylcholine, Jesus, and all the other things that happens, and how that turns on the thyroids and other things. It's cool to see how God did this. And from that standpoint, intellectualism of that is kind of cool. But you always have to look at that in context of the whole. Because the worst thing to do is get into the intellectual side like pharmaceuticals and the allopathic community, because you lose the understanding of how things work. You replace isolated thinking or awareness with isolated thinking. And then you lose the relationships and the synonymouses of the body, of how everything works together. And so then you start treating isolated incidences. And in that, a lot of people get killed. And a lot of people get maimed or injured from this. Just the injuries alone. The death rate is one thing. Look at the injury rate from pharmaceutical use. The injury to the liver and the gallbladder. The injury to the kidneys from pharmaceuticals. You're way out there. So you could safely say tens of millions of people are killed and damaged by allopath and pharmaceuticals every year. Staggering, guys. People just need to wake up and turn a different direction. And that's what this planet needs right now. Don't need to be ascended. We need to fix what you have here. Because the people are constantly here, coming here. Remember, the driving factor of creation is cause and effect. You can't have duality without those laws in place. Those laws in place like that have simply been dubbed by Buddhism as karma and Christianity as you reap what you sow. They're just universal laws that exist that everybody needs to know, including ISIS and all these other people. Everybody needs to know that what you do to others coming right back at you, maybe not in this lifetime, but it will. So when you see someone being beheaded, they probably beheaded someone in another lifetime. I mean, this is just how it all works. And when you understand that, it helps to explain why you see what you see, why some people are in wheelchairs and others are not. How could that poor soul be so damned? But what you don't see is the journey that soul's been through in its journey into creation. Creation is massive. And it's the playground of God. It's the only way God has experience, because consciousness is ever present. It always exists, it always is there, and it doesn't have duality in it. There's no things. All things spring out of that in duality. I have also, and is that one blockage the cause of all my problems? You know, like I said, it can be, you can see multiple problems, whatever they are, from the lymph system, just multiple problems. And then if you're a family where the lymph system has been broken down considerably, or your kidneys and adrenals considerably in their genetic lineage, at your age, you could have a long line of problems that are serious. So the best way, again, to be able to see your journey is to pick a picture of your eyes, real simple, and look at what's karma is there. And that'll be your lacunas, it'll be your crits, it'll be your radius solaris. Take a look at all that, and that's what body you have to deal with. If you're aware enough, you can impose that on your spiritual journey and look at your emotional components, your mental components, compare that to what you've been going through, compare that to your endocrine glands. I mean, there's all kinds of fun we can have in doing those things. At least it's a higher level of intellectualism. Thank you very much. I also have acne, so you know immediately it's tied to this swelling, whether it's a lymph node or a lipoma or whatever. You know that it's tied to your lymph system, of course, because that's what it is. And here you go. Here you go. You have skin problems. And it's all tied to the same, which is one of the most frustrating things I've ever had to deal with, to go through, along with anxiety, stress. So here you go. Your skin problems, because you're saying anxiety slash adrenals are down, slash stress, which the adrenals, the low neurotransmitter, mild eczema, which of course, again, on the neck, of course, is right around where the lump is. On the, so, you know, there you're going in your lymph system. See how backed up your lymph system is? And how your skin isn't opening? So that tells you that the possibility, my friend, of having a little thyroid weakness is there, but a big, not possibility, but probability, you're not filtering well through your kidneys, particularly that left side, and it means the adrenal glands are down too on that side. Going to run you into some low blood pressures and stuff like that as you clean all this up. Fix all this. Fix it all up. And you fix it all up with diet and herbs, my opinion. You get outside of that, now you're treating with isolates and stuff, and no one gets well doing that. You clean out and restore and rebuild, dynamicness, vitality. You are now in Wellville. And that's the stepping stone to God consciousness, let me tell you, in every way. But you can see here, in tracing your journey here, my friend, that you got a lymph system backed up, but at your age, you're going to. I'm also noticing when I urinate, it's difficult to get all the urine out towards the end. Uh-oh. Well, you know, you have to be careful with that, because you could be getting a prolapsed bladder, a bladder that's folding over, a swollen urethra. You could be you could get several things like this, which is all acidosis, leading to the loss of calcium, the augmentation of structure. I mean, anything like this. I want to back away from this. You're young, you got a prostate there, you want to have some good times, I'd back away from this. I would definitely get my kidneys going and get my adrenals up and get moving. And this is going to reach a lot of you guys out there, you know. I feel like an old man or something. And you can. Let me tell you. You can. Listen, there's been. I've had prostate cancer in this, in our clinic at 2. PSAs of 2. Prostate cancer. That's a seriously weakened genetic prostate. Be careful. Get your kidneys filtering, your adrenals up, start cleaning and rebuilding, and fun and life will be yours. Get out of this hell hole. Yeah, you want to fix this one, son. I feel, yeah, big time. I also have lack of confidence and overall unhappiness. Yeah, when you get your adrenals up, you get your energy moving, get all these acids that bring you down, the negativity of acids down, you perk up your parathyroid, which is your happiness about the self, you'll really love the self. Spend time alone with yourself too, my friend, and love yourself. Get away from the body. Don't let the body influence you. Whatever the skin, everything's doing, it's doing, you'll fix all that. You can fix all that. get to the real self. Love the real self. You know, it doesn't matter. You know, spend time alone. You're a good guy. You're a very spiritual person. You wouldn't be writing me these things, Brian. Get that confidence up there. But spend some time alone, because you're the only one that can ride this journey of yours. I'm one of Jehovah's Witnesses, and I'm determined to grow spiritually. Absolutely. Just because you're a Jehovah's Witness doesn't mean you can't grow spiritually. Are you kidding me? No one should ever let their religion stop them from growing. That's what religions are there for, to grow. So however you take that in Jehovah's Witnesses, whether you're one of the chosen or not, you know, let all that go. Get into the self. Because that's why you were produced. You were produced to be God's arm and its experience. Everybody has to accept their divinity, or you wouldn't even be created here. You wouldn't even have consciousness. So accept and enjoy that. You're the right arm of God experiencing that journey. Everything you're experiencing, you're feeding back to the whole. Everything. So you don't let our religions limit us. Some people are letting religions dictate their killing and killing of children and women. It's okay because God says it's okay. You're going to be, yeah, that's bullshit. I don't care who you are. Understand that you can be lied to and by the masses. God isn't there whipping people and you kill half the other people on the planet. You have to wake up to that. God created everything. 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 It's your mind and emotions that's out of whack and out of balance. You have to fix those things. And religions have been real guilty of promoting these things in people. Religion should promote the love and the uniqueness of individuality and the coming together on this planet. You can live by different philosophies and different religions. Big deal. Matter of fact, you have the Socratic, the Pythagorean type of dissertation of the things that you believe in. Okay, fine. But you don't have to kill and hurt others over it. Ridiculous. I want to get my body right as well. Please give me suggestions on my diet and my supplements. All raw fruits, berries, and melons, son. You got enough here. You want to get that out of there. You got to get up that high level. You want that? You want this swollen lymph node, lipoma, whatever it is. You want that out of there. You want that acne off the whatever. It doesn't matter what you call it. You want all that redness off your skin. That's acids. You want all that out of there. Because future could not be good, and being up in here, now you got about your teeth. We've just been talking about the teeth. The thyroid can go down, the parathyroid go down. Maybe it already is because of that unhappiness. You get that parathyroid up, it pulls you out of that unhappiness and puts a smile on your face. And I would probably address my parathyroid. You can address some of the glandulars by using glandulars or using herbs, either way. Berries are the most notorious for helping glands. If you notice, all our thyroid formulas and all this are berry formulas. Even the pituitary loves chaste tree, vitex, berries. So it's interesting how nature has its food for respective tissues. Yep, good stuff. You know, there's two ways of looking at the world. When you stick back from it, you don't care what happens, and you'll be a little happier with it. It's man that's wrecking it. But it's just the unconsciousness is just the way it's supposed to be, but it's also going to be fixed a little bit. We'll see what the future brings here, right? I should be taking for my swollen lymph nodes. We're going to have to go skin and adrenal glands and lymphatics, at least for that lymph node. At least. So I would do two kidney formulas, an adrenal gland formula, and one lymphatic formula at first, particularly a capsuled one. Probably lymphatic 5. If you feel your liver and gallbladder is pretty strong, do lymphatic 5. Do that for about a month, then switch to lymphatic 1 and lymph node, say, 2 or 3. If you can afford the first kit, get your parents to flip your first kit, the best way to go, because you're going to get in your liver, your gallbladder. You're going to kill worms. You're going to get the hold of the funguses. You're going to get into the endocrine glands. You're going to start turning things on. And then kind of keep that idea of kidneys, adrenals, lymphatics, clean up the GI tract, get into that level of thinking. Make sure you're sweating. If you're not, find yourself a steam sauna or get out in this out here. You can just come to Florida and sweat. We have humidity about 95%. So you just go out, you sweat. That's cool. Good way to do it. Now, thanks you so much for your time. Anytime, my friend. Thank you for writing. I appreciate that. Anytime I can help a young person like this, I'm honored to do it. You're a great... Oh, thanks. I'm also curious about your view on the Bible. You are an extremely smart person with all... Oh, thanks, my friend. You've used, I'm very curious on your beliefs. You don't have to answer it if you don't want to. Thanks, Doc. Thank you. But, you know, I was raised Christian. I can't remember. We're just called a Christian church in our little town. And I don't know if there was any denomination hooked to it. I never heard of that. So I was raised basically Christian, you know. Memorized the Bible one time. How we got to go to summer camp free. We memorized the Bible, so we memorized different chapters, different verses, and then go in and tell the preacher or minister, you know, dissertate a chapter and then go study another chapter. But it's enough to say, I always knew there was something wrong with the teachings. I always knew there was something much deeper, that the allegories were allegories, and that I wanted facts. I needed to know. I needed to actually experience. It's one thing to listen, and oh, that sounds good, and I kind of get it intellectually, but I need to get it by experiencing it. And that's where I think religions fail. They get your emotions up, and they get your mind and images up, but they don't give you the true experience. That is everything. Because it's nothing but intellectualism and garbage unless you have a direct experience with God. Well, the only way to have a direct experience with God is to step back from its creation. Because if you're trying to find God in creation, good luck. You'll be spinning for a long time, and you'll be, I don't know what word I want to use. It'll be a while, because you're looking in the wrong place. And it's the looker that's at issue in the first place. So have fun with this, my friend. I think all religions have very valid points, but they also are there to keep the people under control. And when you learn you don't need control anymore, then they set you free. I think religions play a vital role in helping man to understand more morality and maybe even ethics and things like this. But the real experience of God comes when you detach yourself from all of creation and become the creator itself. And you, since you already are that from that, all you have to do is just be your true self. Well, how do you be your true self? Where do we learn where that is? Who can tell us where that is? Nobody. You are simply it already. That's the trickiness of this, is the mind wants you to think, I need someone to tell me who I am. You don't need anybody to tell you who you really are. You already are that. How do you know that? Stop thinking. Stop separating yourselves. Stop looking at your bodies as separate parts and know yourself from the now. Get in the eternal now. And the only way to be there is just to stop thinking. You're already here now. Get beyond the mind. That's your tool that locks you away from God and sets your journey. You use your mind to take you on your journey. That's the thing. The mind is like a little car in Disney World. You get in, and then it takes you on a journey. And you can create your thoughts. You can move your thoughts over here, and you can move your thoughts over there. But who's riding in the car? Who's driving the car? When you discover that, then you'll discover the other where we're going next, and that is into the spiritual fields. Because at a certain point here, I have to let this go a little bit, because I have to bring the other in. Oh no, there's some big things coming. Big things coming. Cool things coming. Good morning, Dr. Morse. I have an inguinal hernia and a vocal cord nodule. I get hoarse and my neck muscles hurt after teaching classes in a technical college. Now listen. You, just like the young man before, we need this out of here. We need that nodule off the voice box, because now you're experiencing the lymph system backing up in your voice box. And the next thing you know can happen, and we don't want that word here, right? So we don't want anything in this area. There's zero success allopathically there, almost 100% deaths with chemo and radiation with this. And you don't want to go anything with what happens when they start getting a knife out. So this is the lymph system, just what that is, mucus. You want to get that lymph system moving. And the only one way is go through the lymph system itself, with the kidneys, the skin, the lymph nodes, and that is, getting the body hydrated, getting your kidneys filtering, and going after that. You really want to go after that. The hernia would be very suggestive of parathyroid. Could be a local weakness genetically, that's popping down your family, but you still want to strengthen that by increasing your parathyroid function, taking maybe the bones formula, and you've got to be able to hold that herniation in long enough to get some healing. The problem with hernias is being able to hold them in to the body doesn't keep stressing that area. That's the problem. If you could go to bed for a couple months, we could straighten that right up and everybody'd be good. But when you're stressing these tissues, it makes it very difficult. They have hernia holders and things, but just work that out. But go under the parathyroid to do that. What you said about the horse and what that cut, because you're creating stressing and under acids. Absolutely, you're talking just, I know exactly what's going on there with you. You have that all the time. The hernia gives me excruciating pain after some time of being standing. Exactly. And that's part of the problem I'm talking about, is trying to get that, because that's always been my problem with hernias, is being able to hold the hernia in place long enough to allow for some good healing of tissue, because, unfortunately, tissue just takes a while to strengthen. Now, with that said, depends on your genes, how bad your lymph system is, and how weak your parathyroid is, to how fast we could strengthen that up. Because I've had people strengthen up their hernia so fast it shocked me. Also, spider veins and varicose veins, same type of thing. Same type of thing. Where are we at? I'm going to have to break here in just a minute. And I think I'll do that right after this. It's getting about 2 o'clock, and I have to go to lunch and have a little meeting. I'm having a birthday party over there for about 3. We have birthday parties for all our people that work for us, and there's 3 of them. They're having birthdays this week, so I guess they had a birthday party over there. How can I be directed to personally ask for any remedy that could heal both conditions? I would call the clinic here, the club, and have speak to a counselor. They'll set you up with a counselor, and they'll take you all through this. It's easy to do. Or if you wanted to, and you can afford it, get the kits. Get the 14-week protocol. If you want me to write you up a protocol, it's $150. You get a hold of one of the girls, and for me, you can get a hold of Valerie. But Megan or Elizabeth can help you. And I would like anything like blood work, any tests and scans that you've had, depending on the nature of what you want me to help you with. Fill out a health questionnaire and send me a copy of your eyes if you can, picture of your eyes. And I'll write you up a protocol for that. That's how we do that, or you make an appointment and have a counselor help you with that. That sort of thing. But the 14-week protocol is already designed for that. I'll say this, I would definitely want to think about the parathyroid, using a bottle of that, at least a bottle or two of that, 1-3 times a day at least. If it's a 10 milligrams, the only thing we have now, I'd probably do 2-3 times a day, a couple bottles. I'd do the bones formula with that. That'll ensure you some good super strengthening. You might want to put some salve on that too. Probably more like a burn salve where you have comfrey in there, and golden seal where you accelerate the healing process of that tissue. So I would want to put some salve on there to help that. Definitely want to strap it in and tie it in, and you have to keep it strapped and tied to work on that if you can. What was the other one? The vocal cord. Ooh, no, this is the one that's a really big one. That one, you want to get that out of there. All that hoarseness is mucus. All that's just mucus. And you want all that out of there. And so that's a detox for sure. The hernia, we want to strengthen. But sometimes you have to detox to strengthen, because there's a lot of lymph around those areas that are just breaking down the tissues. So you have to clean those tissues. Going after the nodule will go after the hernia. with the exception of the parathyroid and the bone stain. So I do that, clean myself up. So you can call that, become a member. Of course, that's $10, and then we give it back to you. So basically, membership in the club is free. And then you have access to the web in there, and everything's in there. We have the diet up there and everything, and we're going to have a research. We're working on our research pages to give you guys some fun stuff there. I can call at any time, or can you call me at there? Just call the clinic here. I hope there is a real cure without surgery for these conditions. Absolutely, George. Absolutely. Absolutely. But the hernia is the one that's going to be the hardest in terms of that. You don't want any surgery on the vocal cords. You don't want to go there. Let me tell you. I just can have you look at a few cases of cancer of the vocal cords, or even just simple tumors on the neck. And, you know, you have to go visit some of them in the ground right now, though. Most of them. Because you can't have the AMA mess with this. Because nothing good comes about messing with the head allopathically. Mm-mm. Daisy, would you say it's okay to eat fruit with some manuka honey on top? Absolutely. Ooh, that would be a good sweet tooth for you right there. Oh, honey on top of fruit. Oh, it tastes so good. Oh, my God. Put honey on a medjool date. And if your toes don't curl, I mean, be careful about a sugar rush on this one. A medjool date is already enough to send you to Never Never Land, let alone honey on it. But I think honey on some fruit's fine. I don't have a problem with that at all myself. You know, I'm not totally a stickler. Can this cure scoliosis? I know this is a response. And I don't know what it's a response to, but it's enough to say if you have scoliosis, there's two things you have to do. One, you have to clean your lymph system, because that's a system pulling your spine out, believe it or not. And that when your muscles, you know, your muscles hold your spine in shape, and your muscles are all blood and lymph feeding cells, and the stronger side, it all on which side, which kidneys are weaker and the stronger, because the stronger side will always pull your spine. The other thing to this, of course, is parathyroid gland. Absolutely. So scoliosis, you want to make sure your parathyroid is giving you plenty of parathyroid and parathyroid. You want to fix your thyroid and parathyroid glands for both calcitonin and parathormone. At the same time, you want to clean your body out, because your back is being pulled, and then you'll end up with compression. You'll end up with losing calcium in the vertebrae. And if it's a lower back, you know already it's the kidneys. But you got to fix your kidneys and adrenals, get your lymph moving down the back. You can use your neural lymphatic points to really help that a lot. Hot and cold showers on the back will help, but parathyroid work at the same time. Scoliosis is definitely not difficult to correct. Never seen anybody that couldn't correct them. So you want to correct this, because you start augmenting those vertebrae too much, it can get some serious problems, including breathing and stuff. So you want to be real careful there. Well, it's been a pleasure. It's always been a pleasure spending time with each and every one of you. I love all of you. And as a team, we do pretty good. You know, no egos here, guys. You know, when there is, let it go. You don't have to leave the flock. You know, we're all going to go in and out. There's a lot of tests that each and every one of us go through. And you're going to go through it with us on here, because I'm one of those way shower dudes. And when you strap with me, they're going to put you through some, initiation, so to speak, some ups and downs. It's all for your good. We got a lot of spiritual masters that work with us, and these guys are strong, to say the least. But your journey will be incredible. So, spend some time with yourself and enjoy yourselves, and be happy. Just hug people and be happy, and know that it's all going to be okay. And you can get your health back no matter what your problem is. Might take you a little time, because time is how things go here. And it just takes time to create things and time to uncreate things. And just work through that. At the same time, you don't have to follow that time. Be in the now. Let the time work itself out. But when you're in the now, you won't even notice how long it takes. And before you know it, it'll all correct itself, and you'll be at another level of experiencing life that is so much fun, so much awake, so much aware, and you'll see all the sleepers. This is a planet of sleepers. But you have to have planets like this, because there's an always creating cause and effect is always going on. There has to be places for souls to go like this. But these places also can come up a little bit, as you're seeing happening now. So, with great love to each and every one of you, keep working with your dreams and out-of-body travels, and have fun with this. Even if you don't believe in that, go after your health and get your bodies healthy. You'll see. And to the next video, love and blessings.